Welcome everyone to my video. Today I am going to talk about overheating issues on our smartphone and how to fix them. In recent time, everyone uses smartphones of different brands. It can be Samsung, it can be Redmi or iPhones, etc. But everyone has one common issue, that is overheating. So everyone is worried and concerned about this thing. And they are taking a lot of care of this problem before buying a particular brand. Like if you are going to buy a Redmi phone, then you should be worried about its overheating nature, and we all know that very well. Now, mobile phones can get warm. Smartphones are electronics after all. So if you are a new smartphone owner and are concerned about your warm mobile phones, then your phone might be okay. But cell phones shouldn't get high temperature. If your cell phone is getting hot and you are concerned that your cell phone might be overheating to the point of becoming damaged or causing damage to something or someone else, especially yourself, then you should certainly try to figure it out what is causing this to happen and how you can stop it from happening anymore. But now, I have some questions to you. Number one is, has your cell phone started getting unusually hot? Number two, does your phone get so hot that it powers itself off? And the last thing on the list is, are you feeling the heat is increasing very fast when you are in multitasking? Then I will describe why you are getting your phone heated up so often and what to do to prevent your phone from overheating issues. Hope you will find the correct solution through this video and would make yourself comfortable about this problem. There are lots of reasons why your phone are heating up so often, so take a look on those things at first. If the back of your phone seems to be heating up, especially where the battery is placed in, then replacing a defective battery is going to be much more affordable and less troublesome than trying to repair or replace a cell phone that is overheating. Number 2, if you have a moderately fast hardware or processor like Snapdragon 615 processor or higher, your phone will heat up as you use it. Actually guys, phones are not like computers. As we all know, in CPU, we all have a heat sink above the processor that consumes the heat, or other cooling systems or multiple fans stays inside the CPU to take all the heat away. But there is no such active coolings in phones. Even the vapor cooling advertised by many phones is just a passive copper heat pipe. More powerful hardware is always going to generate more heat. Although depending on the internal design, some phone may heat more. Internal temperature of around 45 to 50 degrees is normal for phones when you are using them. Number 3 is that your phone will heat up when you play games for over 10 to 15 minutes. This is because when you play games, the processor and the graphics chip have to work at their top speed or close to top speed. This generates more heat. Number 4 is, if you have the phone screen set to very high brightness, it will heat up. This is also the reason why your phone will heat up when you have the camera on, because camera app keeps the screen on and increase the brightness so that you have a nice and bright screen on which you can compose the image. Number 6, when you are charging your phone, a lot of power goes into the phone. This is particularly true for phones with turbochargers and turbocharging. All this energy going inside the phone raises the temperature of the battery, which makes the phone overheated. Number 7 is malware or viruses. Malware on your Android device may well be a problem that causes excessive heat. After all, the developers of malware are not exactly interested in the health of your device. They just want your data. Though it is unlikely to be a virus if you have never checked the Allow installation of apps from unknown sources button in the settings. Now let's talk about how to fix or prevent overheating issues in your phones easily. In recent times, we all are very much habituated with using of multiple apps on our phones. Smartphones have a world of apps called Play Store, and we are so much addicted to those apps, so we download and install those apps without thinking twice. Some of them are used and some of them are not even used. But those unused apps stays in our phones for a long time and we don't care of them. Having multiple apps installed in your phones can make heat and can take that heat to some extent. It also brings your battery life down. So take a little care on this issue and use apps that you need badly, but don't use too many apps on your phone. Number 2. Another thing to consider is the state of your battery and the charger cable. If you have an older phone that has been regularly overcharged, then smartphone overheating can occur. You should never charge to 100% for instance, and regularly charge to 80 to 90% to increase battery life. If the battery itself is not heating up, then the problem is less likely your battery that's causing the problems. But if your battery is old or malfunctioning, then you might want to consider replacing the battery. You might also consider taking your battery out of your phone to check and make sure it is not distorted. If your battery is misshaped or doesn't sit flat on a flat surface, then there is a really good chance that it's a defective and should be replaced. Third thing is that your smartphone is overheating due to the way in which Wi-Fi is being overused. Android users in particular are capable of running apps in the background and drawing on resources, such as CPU and Wi-Fi or mobile internet. If apps are allowed to run in this way, things can heat up, like Google Maps, Google Voice. These kind of apps always continue to take resources from internet through your Wi-Fi and stay updated. So, processor is continuously being used in this whole process. Therefore, running this kind of apps on the background can make your phone heated. Number 4. It is like I talked about in my previous point. Things on a cell phone are like things in a life. If your cell phone has started to unexpectedly get warm or hot, then chances are good that your cell phone has processes such as applications that are running in the background and you don't even know that they are running, some of which might even start running as soon as you power on your phone. So take a moment to have a look at those things and shut them down as you need, and I ensure that you will get lesser heat on your device. So guys, that is how you can bring the heat of your smartphone down and make yourself comfortable. If you guys find this video helpful, then please press the like button. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, so do subscribe and hit the bell icon whenever I upload new videos. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video.